Should you consider an FHA loan as a first-time home buyer when buying a home? We're currently in an environment where everyone has an opinion whether or not you should be buying a house at all because of a potential housing crash. At the same time, they also have opinions on how much money you should spend on your mortgage payment, as well as what type of financing you should do. Well, in this video, we're actually going to talk about FHA loans in more detail and talk about the advantages of them so that you can make the decision for yourself whether or not it's the right loan for you. Now, if you're someone considering FHA, or maybe this is your first time even hearing about an FHA loan, stay tuned through the end of the video where we actually talk about the FHA loan requirements that you need in order to get qualified for one of these loans. Now, how we're gonna start today's video is actually talking about a recent viewer on my channel who used an FHA loan. And the reason I wanna do this is to show you the potential of someone putting a minimal down payment and the advantages, even in our current housing market. Now, this potential gentleman bought a house about 8 months ago. He put 3.5% down, which is the minimum down payment when purchasing a home using FHA. And we'll talk about that more in just a minute. But 8 months later, he's calling my lender because he wants to refinance and get rid of the mortgage insurance on that property. How is that possible? It's because that property gained that amount of equity over the last 8 months. Now, had he waited to purchase until he had a larger down payment, or listened to the naysayers out there saying that FHA loan is a terrible loan, you shouldn't use it, whatever, well, he wouldn't be in the position of owning a home for one, but he also wouldn't be in a position where he could refinance, remove that PMI, and actually have, you know, over 20% equity in his property. He's on his way to building wealth. Now, I'm not here to tell you that an FHA loan is right for you. You have to make that decision for yourself. But I am here to provide the facts so that you can make the decision whether or not you would like to proceed with an FHA loan. As I mentioned at the beginning of the video, a lot of people are going to have opinions on the type of financing that you decide to use when purchasing a home. You're gonna find videos that are for FHA, you're gonna find videos that are against FHA. This video is here merely to provide you with information, education, so that you can make the right decisions. But before we do that, I want to talk about some of the myths out there with regards to FHA financing, and then we're gonna dive into those advantages that I keep talking about. The first myth is that FHA loans are only for first-time home buyers. That is absolutely not true. The second myth out there is that FHA loans are only for those with low credit scores. Also not true. So keep that in mind, you know, when making a decision whether or not to use FHA. Don't get caught up in the myths. Do what's right for you. If you're comfortable with the payment, you're comfortable with the terms, then maybe FHA financing might be the best route to actually get you into a home. Now, here we go. Let's start off by talking about advantage number one of using FHA financing, and that is going to be down payment. FHA allows a minimal down payment, only 3.5% of the purchase price. Whereas conventional financing, yes, they have a 3% down option, but the rates, the terms are way less favorable than that of FHA. At the end of the day, the payment doesn't make sense, but FHA allows a 3.5% down payment down to a credit score of 580. And if you have a credit score lower than 580, it requires a 10% down payment. Now, how does that math work out? Well, if you're buying a $100,000 home, that's a $3,500 payment if you have a credit score higher than 580. $200,000 home, a $7,000 payment. $3,000 home, that's a $10,500 down payment on that property. Whereas going conventional, it may require 10% down, 20% down, depending on your credit score and your debt to income ratio. Now, the second advantage is that FHA allows lower credit scores. They allow credit scores as low as 500, as I mentioned a moment ago, with a 10% down payment. Once you get over a 580 credit score, you can put as little as 3.5% down. But the real advantage is that if you have credit scores in the low 600, 620, 640, your interest rate is going to be considerably better than that of a conventional loan at those credit scores. In fact, a 640 credit score on an FHA loan is going to more or less be the same whether you have a 640 credit score or a 700 credit score. So a huge advantage of using FHA is if you have lower credit scores, you actually get better interest rates with those lower credit scores. The third advantage of using FHA financing is that you can actually qualify for more home using FHA financing than you can that of conventional financing. Conventional loans are a little bit more strict when it comes to your debt-to-income ratio. They really don't want you to go any higher than about a 45% debt-to-income ratio. Your debt-to-income ratio is your monthly debts, including those debts on your credit report, including the new mortgage payment with taxes, insurance, any mortgage insurance, any of that stuff, divided by your gross monthly income. Now, before I tell you how to calculate this, I'm just going to go side note here and go talk to a lender. Talk to a lender before trying to calculate these numbers. Let a lender look at your income, look at your credit report, look at your monthly debts, and tell you exactly how much you can qualify for. People often watch my videos and then they go out and try to calculate these numbers and then they come back and say, hey, I'm approved for this, without ever talking to a lender. A lender is honestly the most important piece of buying a home because they analyze your income, they analyze your debt, they tell you exactly how much you can afford. So that is step number one. And if you don't have a lender, do me a favor, click the link in the description below. I'll refer you to somebody that does business the same way I do. Doesn't matter what state you're in, I'll hook you up. And that person can tell you exactly how much you can afford and they can explain debt to income ratio in more detail. But where I was going with this is debt to income with conventional, you know, they want you to be somewhere in the mid 40% range, whereas FHA allows you to go up to about a 57% debt to income ratio, which means that you can qualify for way more home using an FHA loan than you can that of conventional. And the fifth advantage we're going to talk about today is mortgage insurance. When you put less than 20% down and you're buying a property, you have mortgage insurance on your loan. The less money you put down and the lower your credit score, typically the more that mortgage insurance is going to be per month. Well, with FHA financing, the PMI, the monthly mortgage insurance, is a set fee. And it typically works out that monthly mortgage insurance amount is going to be less than that of conventional financing, which again is going to translate into you being able to qualify for more home. So those are the primary advantages of using FHA financing. At the end of the day, as I mentioned, you have to decide what's right for you. I often get people asking, well, should I just wait and save more money so that I can do conventional financing? Well, you have to figure out, you know, how fast is the market appreciating? How fast can you save money? Does it make sense? Can you get financing now? And are you comfortable with that payment? Do you have money in the bank? Those are all questions you need to ask yourself when going through the process of getting pre-approved and using FHA financing. Now, at the beginning of the video, I mentioned FHA requirements. What I'm gonna do here is throw you to this video where you can find out all the FHA requirements if you're looking at getting an FHA loan. I appreciate you taking the time to watch. Have a great day. Bye-bye.